Humans and animals differ in fundamentally important ways. Sometimes we can't use animal models because it's necessary to understand how humans may uniquely respond to a malfunction, like the mutation that causes Friedreich ataxia, or FA. To do this, scientists have developed laboratory tools. One tool that's become very important is a cell found in human skin called a fibroblast. When an FA patient provides a skin sample to the scientist by getting a biopsy, the scientist can retrieve fibroblast cells and use them in experiments to learn more about why the FA mutation causes the cell to stop functioning properly. These fibroblasts can also be processed in the lab to return them to an immature state, where they are no longer skin cells and instead have the potential to become any kind of cell in the body. These immature cells are called Induced Pluripotent Stem Cells, or iPSCs for short. iPSCs can be grown in the lab where they divide and produce millions of genetically identical daughter cells. Like I said, iPSCs are pluripotent, so they can turn into any cell in the body. This means that iPSCs, originally harvested from skin, can be programmed by researchers to mature into heart, brain, or spinal cord cells. These cell types are very affected in FA, so the ability to study them from a simple skin biopsy is so important. With funding from FARA, Dr. Merrick Napirala has established a bank at the University of Alabama at Birmingham for FA fibroblasts and iPSCs. These bank cells are being shipped to FA researchers around the world, who are using them to understand how FA cells malfunction and to test potential treatments to reverse that malfunction. Without the donation of skin cells and the money to support the cell bank, it would take FA researchers much more time and resources to be able to derive these cells on their own. Many thanks to all the patients and families who have had biopsies to donate cells, and to the community for raising funds and awareness to support this important research tool.
The project we just learned about is One Seed, One Tool, funded by your donations, championed by your engagement and your direct participation in FA research that is necessary to plant, tend, and nourish our garden of therapeutics. Thank you, FA community, for bringing us closer to treatments.